Prime Minister Narendra Modi today launched his much-awaited Gujarat campaign. Interestingly, this time he was speaking only in Gujarati, trying very hard to strike an emotional chord with the people of his home state, hoping that his appeal and his invocation of Gujarati Asmita, Gujarati pride, will help his party overcome all the disillusionment that's been building up over the past several years. Jumana Shah files our lead story on Prime Minister Narendra Modi's appeal to voters in his home state.
Initiating his foray into Gujarat, Prime Minister Narendra Modi reaching out to those who can vote and even those who can't. Speaking in Gujarati, the Prime Minister touched upon his favourite theme of Vikas, but he didn't restrict himself to that.
હાફિઝ સૈદ છૂટી જતો હોય એક આતંકવાદી અને તમને તાળીઓ પાડવામાં મજા આવતી હોય સર્જિકલ સ્ટ્રાઇક વખતે દેશની સેનાનો માન મર્તબો ન કરી શકો તો કઈ નહીં કમસે કમ ચૂપ તો મરવું તું આ ગુજરાતની ધરતી પર આવીને એ ગુજરાતના દીકરાને તમે ભાંડવા માંડો અનાપ શનાપ જૂઠા આરોપો લગાવો કોઈ ગુજરાતી આને માફ કરશે ભાઈઓ બહેનો.
Thereafter, he landed in Saurashtra, a place with a significant presence of the Patel community, which unlike in the past, hasn't been by the BJP side this time around.
Aa Congress party e Gujarat ni andar 4-4 patidar mukhyamantriyo ne jhappi ne besama nathi dida e Congress party no itihas che karan Gujarat કોંગ્રેસને ક્યારે સ્વીકાર કરતું નથી
એમને તકલીફ છે એક ચાવાળો
ધ ઓપોઝિશન વોઝ લેફ્ટ સીટિંગ બીજેપી ફેસિસ 22 યર્સ ઓફ એન્ટી ઇન્કમ્બન્સી ઇન ગુજરાત ટુ કાઉન્ટર દેટ વોટ ઇઝ ઇટ દેટ ધ પ્રાઇમ મિનિસ્ટર ઇઝ બેન્કિંગ ઓન.
There are essentially two takeaways from Narendra Modi's rallies in Gujarat on Monday. First being that his outreach to the Patidar community, where he has invoked the chief ministers of Patel chief ministers of Gujarat, where he's saying most of them were backed by the BJP and not the Congress. In fact, the Congress was against them. The second takeaway that we see is how he has, you know, responded very, very subtly to the Congress's jibe about his policies being pro-elite and anti-poor. Modi is expected back in Gujarat on Wednesday with four more rallies, and there's more to come on this. With cameraman Sajid Alam, Gopi Manyar and Kamlesh Sathar, this is Jumana Shah for India Today in Ahmedabad.
So the Prime Minister was in the Kutch area today. What do locals feel about the work that the Prime Minister has been doing, that his party has been doing in the state? Before I kickstart the newsroom showdown tonight, let me get you this ground report filed by my colleague Preeti Chaudhary from Kutch.
Kutch ne dekha, to kuch ne dekha, Ben.
Now, the entire region of Kutch just has about 6 seats. So, if you look at it politically, it is rather irrelevant, and that could be the reason for its backwardness as well. So, just 6 seats, politically irrelevant, but culturally the backbone of Gujarat. So, there's a reason why we are starting out our journey right at the tip of Kutch, at the run of Kutch. You go alongside another 20-30 kilometers is the border to Pakistan. The reason why we started here is because it's the nerve center in terms of culture to Gujarat, the backbone to Gujarat where the culture is concerned. I have with me, Chacha, kya naam hai?
Moorchang, iska Moor,
aapka naam?
Mera naam Manusaya.
Manusaya ji. Manusaya ji, Kutch ko kya, kyun kehte hai, agar Kutch nahi dekha to kuch nahi
dekha. Kutch ne dekha, to kuch ne dekha, ben. Ye Kutch pura ye, so phidr nahi hai, Dholo nahi dekha to kuch nahi dekha.
To kuch nahi dekha.
Kuch nahi dekha. Dholo nahi dekha kuch nahi dekha. White nahi nahi dekha to ben kuch nahi dekha.
Chunav hai abhi. To kis party ki hawa hai? Bhajab, Congress kya hoga kach mein?
Ye Bhajab hai.
Bhajab hai. Aapko lagta hai Bhajab aayega?
Ji Bhajab hai.
Idhar. So that's the reason why we start our journey. We're going to wait for our bus, our first bus, which we'll take. Then God alone knows how many buses me, my camera person, Mohsin will take through Gujarat. But the journey begins here, right here at the run of Kutch.
The expanse of this one district is overwhelming. The largest district in Gujarat is the most underdeveloped. For locals, it's Narendra Modi who has put Kutch on the tourist map.
ये पूरा जो इस पे टूरिस्ट आया रन पे
जी
जो वो एड था जो गुजरात का कुछ दिन गुजारो गुजरात में
गुजरात में यो अमिताभ बच्चन ने एडवर्टाइज निकाली
हां
कुछ दिन गुजरो गुजरात
में उस एड के पहले कुछ नहीं था यहां
पहले कुछ नहीं था बहन जी
लोग नहीं आते थे
ना लोग आते थे पर वो किसको पता नहीं था ये क्या है इधर रन पे फिर सब फिर वो मोदी जी आए और अमिताभ बच्चन ने आए सब एडवर्टाइज कर दी और सब वाइट में ये बना दिया सब वाइट तो सब लोग आते हैं इधर इधर खुली जगह है घूमने की बस
आते हैं
वो मजा मानते हैं इधर
तो आप किसको वो श्रेय देंगे मोदी जी को देंगे
जी हम मोदी जी को देंगे हम मोदी का आदमी है सर जी हां हमको मोदी का आदमी है
क्या बोलेंगे हूं मोदीनु मानस छु
जो मोदीनु मानस छु गुजराती में बोलते हैं
क्या बोलते हैं
जी हूं मोदीनु मानस छु और हिंदी में बोलते हैं हम सब वो मोदी के आदमी है
सो यू नो दैट्स द मेन रीजन एंड द पीपल हियर यू नो द लोकल्स द ट्राइबल्स दैट वी हैव बीन स्पीकिंग टू दे डू गिव द क्रेडिट टू नन एल्स But our Prime Minister, that when he was Chief Minister, it was he who popularized this entire run of Kutch. And that is why today we see the kind of footfall that this place enjoys. Especially jo foreign tourist aata hai na, wo jyada ho gaya hai.
Jyada hota hai, Benji.
Jyada ho gaya.
Jyada aata hai.
But move beyond the stunning white desert and the Gujarat development model is wanting.
So aap kahan se pura ye local bus lete hain har din apna? अप डाउन करते
हैं लोकल बस में ही अप डाउन करते हैं क्योंकि एसटी की फैसिलिटी नहीं है
क्या फैसिलिटी नहीं है
एसटी
वो क्या होता है बस सरकारी बस का फैसिलिटी नहीं है यहाँ पर सिर्फ लोकल बस चलता है
सरकारी चलता है पर जो रिक्वायरमेंट है उतनी नहीं आती है
उतना नहीं आता है
और टाइम भी एडजस्ट नहीं होता है उसका
क्यों जा रहे भुज बीमार है सब सर्दी से बुखार है कितना कितना बड़ा है
चार महीने का बस
यहाँ पर अस्पताल है
हाँ भुज में बहुत
भुज में है पर आप कितना दूर रहते हो भुज से
30 किलोमीटर
30 किलोमीटर जाना पड़ता है भुज और बस नहीं मिलता है तो लोकल बस लेना पड़ता
है Onwards to Bhuj, the nerve center of arts, craft and culture.
पहले जीएसटी के पहले हम कुछ टैक्स हमारे पास नहीं लगता क्योंकि हम आर्टिजन कारीगर हाथ से मेहनत करते हैं तो हैंडीक्राफ्ट बेस के ऊपर कभी भी टैक्स नहीं था कोई जात का भी और हम भी छोटे लोग हैं तो जीएसटी हमको इतना पता भी नहीं चलता क्या रहता है क्योंकि हम जो काम करते हैं उसमें एक हाथ से पैसा लेते हैं एक हाथ से हमारा जो बना हुआ शॉल है वो देते हैं तो उसमें हमको जीएसटी का नियम भी नहीं पता रहता इतना क्या है अभी भी हमको जीएसटी इतना समझ नहीं आ रहा है जैसे हमको रॉ मटेरियल भी लेना है तो उसके लिए भी जीएसटी चाहिए तो वो भी एक बहुत बड़ा रॉ मटेरियल हमारे लिए बहुत महंगा हो गया है जो हमको ये बोले 1400 समथिंग पर केजी मिल रहा था लेकिन अभी 1700 है तो डायरेक्ट 300 रुपये है वो हमारे छोटे लोग के लिए बहुत बड़ी रकम रहती है
Kutch is a land of immense pride, yet immense want. Waiting for decades now for its vote to be counted for. With Preeti Chaudhary in Kutch, Bureau Report, India Today.
Can the Prime Minister's emotion plus Gujarati Asmita card help diffuse this discontent that's been building up in Gujarat? Joining us on the Newsroom Showdown tonight, Dr. Sambit Patra representing the BJP, squaring off against him, the Congress's media in charge for the state, Pawan Khera. I want to go across to Pawan Khera first because, Pawan, you saw in that ground report filed by Preeti from Gujarat, the moment the Prime Minister comes in, starts playing the emotional card, there is a section of voters in the state who may be upset with Vijay Rupani, may be upset with the BJP government in the state, but they feel a connect with Modi. The fact that he's Prime Minister, the fact that he's their man, he's Gujarat's man, he's shining at the national, international stage. Are you concerned that this last minute blitzkrieg by the Prime Minister could help the BJP overcome the campaign that you've built the last several months?
Not concerned about what you said, Rahul, but we are definitely concerned about this obsession with I, me, myself of Honorable Prime Minister Mr. Modi. He is not the only son of Gujarat. The poor farmer is also a son of Gujarat. The Dalit who was beaten up in Una is also a son of Gujarat. The trader who is agitating against GST is also a son of Gujarat. Why does he ignore all those sons and children of Gujarat and he only talks about himself? People of Gujarat are not fools. They know they can see through this. You can't just make people emotional when they are looking for jobs and they are not getting any jobs. What is this rhetoric? How many times will he use the same rhetoric to fool people? People refuse to be fooled this time by Mr. Modi. The issues at hand are Jai Shah, our Rafael scam, our GSPC scam, is GST, demonetization, unemployment. He cannot run away from these issues and talk about emotions and talk about Gujarati Asmita. After all, the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Patel, they are from Gujarat. We are all, Gujarati. We are all Gujaratis by that standard. So how can he just
Sambit Patra,
claim that he's the only Gujarati?
You saw in that report from Kutch anger
anymore
about the GST. You know, some may have liked Prime Minister Modi and what he's done, but they were very angry. Samajh mein nahi aa raha GST, it's a headache as far as that small weaver is concerned. Now the reality is, an emotional card can work once, it can work twice. Can it work again? Because there are lots of people, as Pawan Khera says, who are jobless, who are upset. You've got the patidar agitation. Do you believe just Prime Minister Modi's emotional appeal, invocation of this Gujarati Asmita, can help diffuse all the discontent, Dr. Patra?
See, Rahul, I was following the report presented by India Today very keenly, and the report itself said that the Prime Minister in speech in fact did not restrict himself only to development, in the sense that he spoke mostly about development, but thereafter he also made a call as far as the tweet by the Yuva Congress was concerned that they wanted me to sell tea. Yes, I sold tea, I would further sell tea also, but I would never sell this country. Well, yes, he did not restrict only to development. He spoke about other issues as well. And so be it. We have to speak about every issue. But most importantly, while I was seeing your report, the thing that caught my attention and my heart as well was when a simple poor man in Kutch said that "Hu Modi nu manas che." I am Modi's man. And this is what we all say, that I am Modi's man. That's what he was saying. And remember, one person does not become other person's friend or does not consider the Prime Minister as his own until and unless something concrete and tangible has been done on the ground. As far as GST is concerned, remember, it is essential that the country moves ahead. And hand-holding is something what Mr. Narendra Modi has spoken. That, well, yes, if people have problem, we would stand by them. The administration would handhold them and would see to it that in the days to come, in the months to follow, they don't have these problems. Already, certain fine adjustments have been done. You're aware of that, Rahul. So naturally, that is not the problem. The policy and reforming, transforming the country and performing is not the problem.
Pawan Khera, maine chai bechi hai, desh nahi becha, is a powerful message from the Prime Minister. Once again, the Congress scoring a self-goal in 2007, it was Sonia Gandhi herself calling Modi maut ka saudagar. That boomerang badly on your party. Now he's picked on that. You've apologized for it, but the Prime Minister can clearly pick on it and build on it. Say, you're calling me derisively a chai wala. I'm selling tea, but I haven't sold the nation. Is that a costly blunder?
I think ye dono hi statement unke jhoothe hain, maaf kijiyega. He's our Prime Minister, I should not be talking like this, but na to unhone kabhi chai bechi. 1973 mein Varnagar station aaya, to forget that myth that he has created around himself. Aur na wo ye bhi galat hai ki wo desh nahi bech rahe. Bhai, why can't he respond to Rafael scam? Why that silence? It's a loud silence. Everybody can hear that silence. What about Jai Shah? Everybody knows what's happening there. What about GSPC? It's the CAG report, not the Congress party spokesperson, who is pointing fingers. It's the CAG report that has indicted the Gujarat government, headed then by Mr. Modi. But Having said that, why wouldn't he come out straight and talk about the indebted farmers? If the Gujarat model was so great, why is there a demand for reservations in almost every corner of the state? That explodes the myth of the so-called Gujarat model, of the so-called vibrant Gujarat. It's enough now. He has tried to make fools of everybody. Now people of Gujarat can see through it. They refuse to buy this rhetoric. They want answers. And these questions have been articulated by Rahul Gandhi, by all other leaders of the Congress, after having heard the Man Ki Baat of the Gujarati voter. Mr. Prime Minister can only talk about his Man Ki Baat. When will he start listening to people? When will he start responding to people?
Sambit Patra, Nirmala Sitharaman, our defense minister, at a press conference promised to make public the per fighter aircraft rate of the Rafale deal. Many days have passed, inquiries have been made, those details still haven't been put out. The Congress leveling corruption scam charges against the BJP, are those hurting you? And secondly, why aren't these details being made public, asks the Congress.
See, first and foremost, Rahul, look at the Congress media in charge from Gujarat, my good friend Mr. Pawan Kheda. Outrightly, despite the fact that he is a Gujarat in charge, outrightly he is calling out the Prime Minister jhoota hai. Wo jhoote hai, wo sab jhooti bolte hai. I mean, don't you think this is going to hurt a Gujarati? You are the in charge of the media of Gujarat state, and you non-stop, in fact, calling and abusing the Prime, calling names to the Prime Minister and abusing him. And do you expect that we are not going to speak to the people of Gujarat, that they should see what the real intention of Congress party is? Secondly, Rahul, I was making a point that you said that Congress party has built up a campaign. My simple question is, where is the campaign of the Congress party? The Congress has outsourced the campaign. I don't hear of any Bharat Singh Solanki over here. I don't hear of who would be the chief minister candidate as far as the Congress party is concerned. All I hear of are three boys of Gujarat who were never part of Congress party up till now. So it is outsourcing of the election campaign as far as the Congress party is concerned. Do you believe, Rahul, that this is the way that the Congress can think of even winning, coming anywhere closer to winning Gujarat election without any campaign on the ground?
Pawan Kheda, is that not a big concern? And as the far fact as that the Congress's booth management on the ground, your last mile connectivity, is seen as a problem area in Gujarat, that the BJP is thought as having a more robust organizational machinery on the ground with their Panna Pramukhs, Amit Shah doing all these booth level meetings. Their ability to get their voters out on that crucial voting day as an organizational machine probably much higher and sharper than that of the BJP, than that of the Congress, Pawan Kheda.
First of all, Rahul, when we question the Prime Minister for having misled the people of Gujarat, for having insulted the people of Gujarat by repeatedly misleading them, we are not questioning the Gujaratis. We are questioning the man from Gujarat who is misleading Gujarat. Nothing wrong in that. Let them try this emotional rhetoric. It will not work. Third, he is saying, where is the Congress campaign? The Congress campaign comprises of very uncomfortable questions. And we are all waiting for the answers, Mr. Sambit Patra, and I'm sorry, neither the Prime Minister nor Mr. Amit Shah, who controls the remote control for Gujarat, yahan ka mukhyamantri nahi hai, wo sirf rubber stamp hai. Yahan ka remote control Amit Shah ke haath mein hai. Jab wo chahte hain Anandi Ben ko nikal bahar karte hain, jab wo chahenge Rupani ji ko bhi bahar kar denge. Khair, Rupani ji ko to ab voter bahar karega. The issue is, you spoke about booth management. Rahul, BJP has always been a cadre-based party. They've always had a very strong booth-level presence. How many times have they won the entire country? So it's not the booth, it's the emotion of the voter. Aap kitne hi worker khade kar dijega, agar paid worker khade kar dijega, agar voter jisko vote dena chahta hai, kya aap andar bhi, unless EVMs are, that's their headache. I don't want to get into that. We'll get into that whenever you debate that issue. Because there is a lot of suspicion amongst the voters in Gujarat for the first time I've seen. So, okay, it is the voter who decides and not the worker. Let us be very clear about that. And the voter has made up his and her mind. Come what may, they are desperate. Rahul, they are striking out dates on the calendar. They are waiting for the 9th and the 14th to give a farewell to this government.
Sambit wants to respond to you, because we've seen in Delhi, we've seen in Bihar, when the voter turns against a particular party, then this whole business of panna pramukh, page pramukh, booth management, poll management, all of that doesn't count for very much when the people rise against you.
Rahul, something very interesting has happened right now. In a way which could not be hidden, Mr. Pawan Khera, the Congress spokesperson, even blamed the EVM right today, saying that, well, until unless the EVMs are managed. So they are already in search of a scapegoat, you know, and they're trying to protect Mr. Rahul Gandhi, who is to be elevated as the Congress chief within no time, I believe, and that is going to happen before the Gujarat elections. So blaming the EVM even before the elections have started is accepting the fact that they have lost the elections even before the votes have been cast. Secondly, and most importantly, let me tell you, as far as the Gujarat elections are concerned, what does the Congress have to offer apart from abuses and apart from falsities? Is there any roadmap of development that the Congress party can talk about? Absolutely not. These are the very people who are opposing even the bullet trains advent only a few days ago. These are the very people who did not want GST, very people who did not want demonetization. People of Uttar Pradesh, in fact, gave a befitting reply because they were saying that everything is lost after demonetization and people would not vote for Narendra Modi again. And we saw what was the result in Uttar Pradesh. So for God's sake, we may have rhetorics in election, but please don't attack the perform, transform and the change environment Reform. That the India today has. We all have to create a new India, and this kind of rhetoric is not going to help new India.
You know, because the Prime Minister also attacked the Congress, Pawan Khera,
Rahul,
for the tweet put out by Rahul Gandhi on Hafiz Saeed being freed by the Pakistani army. He's saying that this is something that's being done by the courts in Pakistan. Why is the Congress getting so happy if Hafiz Saeed walks away? The moment the Prime Minister he gives it back to Rahul on his haglomacy, that also is something that begins to hurt. Pawan.
First of all, when you question someone, you're not abusing that person. Let these arrogant people in government today, including the spokesperson, my dear friend Sambit Patra, understand this very clearly. If I'm questioning the Prime Minister, I'm sorry, I'm not abusing him. Be very clear about that. You kept questioning us, we never took it amiss. It was your right. Rahul, 26-11, the Prime Minister was then Chief Minister of Gujarat. Bombay was not in his jurisdiction. He went, held a press conference, abused the Congress government, left, right and center. Was he applauding the attack? If we are upset about what's happened with Hafiz Saeed, how did he get released despite your diplomacy? Despite your going and cutting the cake with Nawaz Sharif? Despite your flirting around with the Western leaders? What has gone wrong? Why can't we question? That's our not just our duty, it's our right. And they have a problem with questions? Why?
Sambit Patra, the Prime Minister tried to spin it in a way.
2003 से लेकर आज तक मेट्रो बनी नहीं हम बुलेट ट्रेन को क्वेश्चन नहीं करें क्यों नहीं करें साहब वी विल क्वेश्चन इट
संबित पात्रा द प्राइम मिनिस्टर
आप बता दीजिए EVM की बात हम नहीं कह रहे द वोटर सेज कि अब तो सिर्फ EVM बचा सकता है ये हम नहीं कह रहे यहां का वोटर कहता है
संबित पात्रा द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ट्राइड टू स्पिन इट इन अ वे सजेस्टिंग दैट राहुल गांधी वाज सेलिब्रेटिंग व्हेन हफीज सईद वॉक्ड फ्री दैट्स नॉट द फैक्ट दैट वाज एक्चुअली अ ट्वीट लेस्ट विद सार्केज्म व्हिच हैड राहुल गांधी क्वेश्चनिंग योर डिप्लोमेसी दैट्स अ बिट ऑफ अ tongue twister, your diplomacy, where you were going and meeting Nawaz Sharif and nothing came of it. That wasn't a celebration, that was a tweet oozing with sarcasm, and yet the Prime Minister in the battlefield of Gujarat chooses to present that as Rahul rejoicing when Hafiz Saeed walked free.
No, but the Prime Minister was absolutely right. What is rejoicing and what is celebration? Celebration is when you find an occasion to attack the Prime Minister of a country rather than opposing the enemy nation. If Pakistan has released Hafiz Saeed, then rather than tweeting against Pakistan and admonishing Pakistan's court for what it has done, rather than saying that Pakistan today is terroristan, your first quote is a sarcasm on Indian Prime Minister, saying that Indian Prime Minister has failed on diplomacy, and that's the reason as to why Hafiz Saeed is released today, is only providing oxygen to the Pakistani dispensation. That is what Pakistan has been maintaining, that we don't follow orders from United States, we don't in fact endorse the fact that India has good relations with the United States, and you have the opposition party of India in fact rhyming the same words of Pakistan. So naturally these issues are of importance, which would be taken up by the Prime Minister of the country. And let me tell you very frankly, Rahul, without mincing any words, I mean, for the opposition party today, one of the members says that he will skin Mr. Narendra Modi alive, while we have the others who stand rather by the enemy nation than with Mr. Narendra Modi. These parties will go to any extent, mark my words, any extent to see to it that Narendra Modi be removed from the seat of India's power, because these parties feel that they are the ones who are entitled because of their surnames to be in the throne of India. And that's the reason as to why we see
time, gentlemen, on this debate.
That the Rahul Gandhi,
I'm out of time. Pawan has his hand up, so I'm going to give you, Mr. Khera, 20 seconds. Just 20 seconds, please.
Was Mr. Modi siding with Pakistan on 28 November after the Bombay attacks? When he went and attacked Dr. Manmohan Singh instead of attacking Pakistan, was he standing with Pakistan? What kind of an argument is this?
But remember, Rahul Gandhi was partying then.
He did not attack Pakistan.
Rahul
there.
Gandhi
he
was
went
a
and
party
spoke against
then.
Dr. Manmohan Singh's government. No, forget it. That's a rumor. You were party. Your propaganda machinery can keep spreading any rumor.
Just imagine.
Mr. Modi stood there.
Everyone
in front
knows
of
that Rahul Gandhi was
and
out partying.
Spoke out against Dr. Manmohan Singh, not against Pakistan. Was he siding with Pakistan? Was he speaking the language of Pakistan? I'm not even talking about people going, your ministers going to Kandahar along with Mr. Ajit.
Okay, gentlemen, I'm out of time. The heat in this election is rising, not just in our studios, but also out on the battlefield. The kind of sharp, shrill rhetoric we saw today is what we'll see a lot more of. Prime Minister Modi invoking his ultimate political brahmastra, appealing to Gujarati Asmita. If this works, it can turn the election, which shows vote share percentages in the opinion polls come down. But that could change depending on how Prime Minister Modi's campaign plays out over the next 2 weeks. We've got the best team of reporters and editors on the ground tracking this election for you. Not just the debates, also a lot of solid ground reportage. We're slipping into a break. When we come back, Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.